And I said, good morning. I had to open my mic again. Otherwise you won't hear a thing. And me neither, because it's on my monitor. Welcome back. It's November 28th, Thanksgiving in the US. Happy Thanksgiving. I have to do some things here to get ready. Running a little bit late. Good morning. I'm going to do another live stream, office development. I'm wearing my very old shirt, office shirt, and it's so old that it has some stains on it. It's actually my working shirt. When I'm painting my house or do other things, fixing stuff. So let's start the show. Welcome back. Let's go into the developer machine. There we are. What's this? The security thingy. Turn my virus protection on. Not sure why this is disabled every now and then, but that should be on. Not that it matters much, because it's VM. I can dispose it whenever I like and kick in a new one. Start the command window. Where we left off last Tuesday, I think, was extending the ribbon. But when we change the ribbon over to a custom tab, like putting a button on the additional in an extra tab, a custom tab, then the add-in would not run properly. And let's see if we can reproduce this and fix it, hopefully today. CD data projects. Test commands, code, let's take my show notes with it. I feel I have some sneeze coming up. Bless me. So what you're doing with what's it called, Thanksgiving? Oh, by the way, Thanksgiving for the US, it's now 21:49, so it's not even Thanksgiving for you today. The East Coast is, however, in Thanksgiving, 0049 a.m. Check some things here. Where are we? So when we change over the office tab in here to something else, that breaks. First, let's run this and see if it's working like this, like we left it on Tuesday. Hopefully my stream lighting gear will be here today, or maybe tomorrow if it's delayed. With Black Friday, there was this great deal last week, or early this week, I think, where they had some discount of 25% on the Elgato stream lighting. Yeah. PVManageGG, thanks for stepping by and following. How are you doing this morning or this evening, depending where you are, where you're from? Throw something in the chat room if you want to talk to me and have a discussion. Hi there, how are you? West or East Coast? Are you already on Thanksgiving? Or do you still have to wait? East Coast, so you're already in Thanksgiving. Unless you're in Chicago or something, then you still have to wait an hour, I think. Welcome to the stream. What I'm doing is customizing Word applications in this case. I'm also looking at customizing Excel and the other office hosts by extending it with JavaScript. And one of the items to change is the ribbon. If you start up, let's kick the application in and see what it's doing. Are you a developer? What are you doing as a developer, if you are a developer? It's kicking in Node now. Basically, it's just a web application and it's running in the background for the Office extensions. Running Node. That should kick in Word, and it does. Created this button. Yeah, this is an error that I get from Word somehow. I'm not sure why. And I'm unable to get rid of it, but it's independent of my add-in. We use regular Java. Okay. So are you developing for... currently taking a course data structures. As in, what kind of data structures? So if you use Java, I would think you are on Linux or something. There's the button from the add-in. If I click on it, then there should be an add-in here. And it does. And the reason for it to appear in the Home tab is that there is this item, Office tab. And now, according to documentation, you should be able to change this over to Custom tab and give it some specific ID. Tab Custom. But if I run this, and I close this one, kill Node, then the application is not running for some strange reason. And maybe it's because the one of the other items is incorrect. Kicks in commands. And what's in commands? There's nothing in here other than loading the Office.js. Wait, this one maybe? Yeah, the commands HTML is kicking in the JavaScript engine. You learn about linked lists and queues, stacks, trees, and more, and maps. That sounds like you're in school, are you? Because linked lists and queues are usually the first items that you learn when programming. So I wonder why you selected Java, or is that a selection that was made by, for instance, school or your employer? Yes, second year of college, I recognize that. I have a degree in computer science, and my language at the time when I got this degree was with C++. C Sharp was not around at the time, and building your first software when we had developer classes was with things like linked lists and queues and whatnot. Like I think the first one was like learning variables and arrays and all these kind of things. Over the time, there are a lot of languages are added, but C++ was the main language in college. So you have a good job ahead if you get through this, because there's a high demand of developers and IT people in general. So continue with that, I should say. And the TypeScript thing in the background in here is that there are, let's see, notification system, notification completed. It's loading Office at startup, the Office engine. And git global, nothing much that's related to the ribbon items. So it should not be affecting anything if we change this over to custom tab. Google Office.js custom tab. I'm from the Netherlands, so that's the other side of the world. And at this time it's 7 a.m. in the Netherlands, in Europe. So we are about 6 hours ahead, I think, if you are New York based. Custom tab element in the manifest file. This is the documentation. So if you change this over to custom tab with a custom ID, and you put a group in there and a label, then you should get something in your custom tab. But if I run this, however, it's kicking in anyway, I think. Usually I start with npm start, but F5 appears to be running as well. Although I don't see the node window yet. Where is it? Come on. Nothing happening. There's a big donut. Well, not very good. You will learn it anyway. In the beginning, it's quite confusing. But hang in there. And at some time, you will get the hang of it. And it will all be clear to you. I remember that, especially in the beginning, it was quite confusing. I'm not sure why this is giving me the donut and doing nothing. Let's do this npm start anyway. Oh, there's a... Yeah, and the reason for this is I forgot to change the end tag to custom tag, tap, I should say. And now I need to start again, npm start. So you're probably building not the most fun things at this time. Just some basic lines of code. That's not the most pleasant thing to do. Because you will really want to build something. Node is still trying to load. There it is. But you already notice that as soon as it hits the ribbon, there's this add-in error. And it's not showing anything. It says the add-in is no longer available. Add-ins inserted during development are only available during debugging from Visual Studio. And that's not even true. Please open your project in Visual Studio and rerun your application or deploy your add-in into a valid catalog and reinsert. So if you follow the instructions over here, that would mean that it's not finding this folder, and what it's looking for is the manifest. That's this one. And the question is, why isn't not finding this when it just changed the custom tab? So let's try something else here and create a complete new add-in, like starting Yo Office. Yo is the Yeoman generator, and Office is the type of application that we are generating using Yeoman. This will guide you through some options to what to create. In this case, a word add-in. Let's kill word before we run this. Now you see, welcome to the Office add-in generator by Office Dev. And Office Dev is the Twitter add-in. What we are building is quickly is a new React framework add-in. Using, I think we used TypeScript in this one. Yes, Alt TSX. TypeScript. Make this test commands 2. So I just want to compare it. created in Word. Now it's generating. Doing a degree in computer science, I'm not very good at it, but it's fun to learn. It will be even more fun if you get ahead of it and try to develop real applications. The best way, by the way, to learn programming is think of a goal that you want to build, some sort of a small application, for instance, a movie database or something that you're collecting and making an application to administer your collected items, and just start building. Start from scratch and see where it ends. If you run into issues, just go out to Google and there are a gazillion options there that allow you to find the issue. At least that's what I hope, because I have an issue right now and I haven't found a solution yet. Custom tab add in, not found. Add in step not showing Ribbon 2016. That should be saying like custom tab. Oh. Custom tab add-ins manifest XML not working. October 20. That is quite recent. I hope it's not the same as I got. You need to provide more detailed information, such as relevant part of manifest to build Excel. Cindy Meister. Cindy Meister is around. From when is this item? This month, I should think. Cindy Meister used to be another Word MVP, Microsoft MVP. That means a Microsoft MVP is someone who is awarded with the MVP award, MVP.microsoft.com. And if you are recognized as an MVP, then you get some special things, like you're allowed to go to the Microsoft campus and visit the development teams and discuss everything. But this is an annual thing, and you can get this award throughout the year, and then it's renewed at the 1st of July if you are still in a way that you are MVP. And Cindy was one for Microsoft Word. So let's see what's her comment. And there was not much information in here, so you need to get more information in when you're asking the questions. Could you please move more information? Yeah, repeating. We use manifest add-in commands. Please refer code. We use manifest add-in extension point. Custom tab, Contoso tab. And Contoso, that's the fake company that Microsoft always uses when they are demoing. After inserting manifest from add-ins, XML is not showing. Thanks for providing you looking into it. Any update? No. And I think I see the same thing with my Word add-in. So it finished generating the test command too, and now I should go into cd test command 2 code, and now immediately change the add-in before running it. Go back to the manifest XML where the definition is for the extension points, like office tab, change it into custom tab and make that tab custom. Also, don't forget to change the end tag, there it is. Now throw in the terminal, npm install. I think this is already done by Yeoman, but just for to make sure that we got everything in. Wow, what's this? Skipping optional dependency. Okay. It's a warning, so I can ignore this. FS events. Not sure why that's used. Start this. There's an old node running in here. Start this. npm start. That should build our test commands to add in. You can notice there's a new add-in and it's already failing. So let's make the font a little bit bigger, otherwise it's completely unreadable. There should be a button in a special group in here, and it's not. So I'm really curious why this is not working. So I need to create another question in here. Let's search for custom tab. Custom tab. Stack Overflow, by the way, is that's the website to go to if you have questions around programming. Some people don't program on their own, but they are just using the Stack Overflow code and copy everything into their application and build your application by doing it that way. There's also a book cover, a fake book cover. It's called How to Program Using Stack Overflow, something like that. How to catch errors, use Chrome custom tabs, and I should put something more in here like Office. How to share the same custom tab in multiple hosts. How can I make the custom tab with the add-in I've created that only appears blah blah blah. Office.js custom tab and worksheet visibility does not work. No, that assumes that it's working anyway. Start from scratch is false. Manifest file does not conform the schema. Cannot load Office add-in. I created a sample manifest Office, but there's some issue in the XML scheme. Commenting contents of the overrides, blah blah blah. Let's see what's in here. Extension point, custom tab. Create a sample manifest file for Office Add-in, but there are some issues with XML schema. I am commenting contents of version overrides with itself. The editing works fine. If anyone can tell about the issue, the source location and file location. Note the source location in the function file is available in my workspace. Attaching manifest code. Problem resides. The problem in your manifest is that you are using the following line, resource label 5, but you do not define resource label 5. The manifest only works if you define all resources that you use. Yeah, but that's... If I'm looking at this one... Let's close this. And just for kicks, let's change back the custom tab. Revert it back to... Office tab, like this. Now npm start again. That should give us the clean add-in. Why is this still a small font? Oh, I'm not want to zoom in Word. Zoom in note. Maybe I need to change this permanently. Edit the properties, make this font a little bit bigger. Properties 28. Yeah. Running in the background, and now you see it's actually running in here. This is a custom tab. So what's the custom tab in ScriptLab? Custom tab ScriptLab. Maybe on GitHub. Hands-on master labs, custom tab script lab. Where's script lab? There's script lab. It's also showing custom lab maybe somewhere in the code. Go to script lab. Manifest. Outlook. And this is not the add-in itself. What's this? Yeah, this is interesting. You can run this from Azure, I think. There you have it. That shows that the ScriptLab add-in in here, like this, it's actually a website. If I can make this bigger, come on. For some reason it's still keeping everything loaded. Don't save. I close all my applications. Because I have this running donut, it's not sure why there's a running donut in here. Close, still a running donut. Task manager. Cool. What's running here? CPU? Windows update? What's this for a thing? Let's log off of my sign out. My developer machine. And where is it? That doesn't even work, I think. Oh, it is. But I need to log in again with my Azure portal. Where does it go? There. It's on my other screen. Connect. I'm doing this on my other screen, otherwise my credentials will be all over the interwebs, and that's not what I want. Connect. And login. Almost there. There we are. And it's back. And there's no running down it anymore. Command. CD data projects. Test command 2. Code. So I'm not sure why the custom tab is not working, because it used to work. I tried this I think several years ago, when the version was still the beta version. Custom tab. Let's go to GitHub first. GitHub. Let's go to just the root of GitHub and search for something with custom tab in there. So custom tab. See if there's something with Office. JavaScript. Custom tab, custom tab, custom tab. This is custom tab. Office. No. Then try to find Script Lab. Script Lab. It's even easier if we go to, I think, Office Dev. Yes. There, Script Lab. Now let's find something with custom tab in there. In this repository, yeah. There it is. It says ID tab playground. It's also tab playground in there. Alpha scriptly react localhost script lab production. Production sounds like a valid option. This is probably the manifest file. Manifest, yes. Let's see how many manifests are in here. Fix broken tests. Fix manifests. Last year, so this is already a year old. When swimming in the ocean, quickly go into production and check the extension point, custom tab. This is a big, big, big manifest file. There's the end of the custom tag. So if I copy all of this from custom tab to this is, by the way, providing a different one. Which one is this? Manifest extension point type custom functions. Desktop factor. These have several commands, like creating the group, then putting a button in there with some super tips, show task pane, then another button, the run command, and another button. Use the same run tab title. Use the same run tab title and task pane ID, but pointing to a different URL. Okay. Look at this one. The icons are, these are, I think, mandatory. Custom tab office.js. Custom tab element. On the ribbon, you specify the tab and group for the add-in. This can either be on the default tab, home, message, or meeting. That's related to Outlook, I should say. Group label, and these are required. Group and label are required. So this is the minimal one. ID and the label required. See group element. Group element. Defines a UI, a group of UI controls in a tab. On custom tabs, the add-in can create up to 10 groups, regardless of which tab it appears on. Add-ins are limited to one custom tab. Child elements require a label and a control. That's interesting, because if you look at the other one, it does not show a control. Label, label. Should have a label and a control in the group. Group ID. Still. Should work if you just change it over. Let's see. What was mandatory? Label and. Is it a group? Yeah, the other one. Group and the label is required. So, a group. And a label. Group and a label is required. And that's not in there. Is that also with Office tab? In the Office tab, the label is not required. Office tab. This one. Office tab. Where's the documentation group? So the only one required in here is a group and not a label. So if I copy the label, where is it? Where's the resource for this? There. Let's first copy this. Copy. Oh, let's not mess this up. Copy this and make this commands group. It's not a group, it is a ribbon, a tab. Commands tab label. Commands tab. Then we copy the label. Make sure that outside the office tab we also have a label in here. And the resource ID is then called commands tab. Where is it? Commands tab in here. So now we have the mandatory group and label. And now make this custom tab. Custom tab. Oh, darn it. Copy. Change the end tag. So now we have a match. Anything else? In here it's now having the primary command service. We put in a custom tab. And in the custom tab, we have a commands group. And the commands group needs to be in place with, let's see, the custom tab has the group and the label. And the group is this one. No, this is the office tab. The group is in this one. It needs an ID. We have an ID, but it's tab home, and I want to change this over to tab custom. So it is a unique ID. It contains a mandatory label and a control, but there is a control. I need a control in here, in the group. A label and a control, and the control in this case is the button, task pane button. That should be okay. And what it's doing, it's showing the task pane specified in this URL. Looks good. Let's take this to the test. npm start. Clicking word. Yeah, there it is. Yay! Why kick away the errors in here? So we have a winner in here. Ta-da, drum roll. Kappa Gin. Is that working? That's not working. Why it's not working? My command's not working. Google. Kappa Gin. I think it's... Twitch. Kappa Gin. Double P. Oh. Hmm. Kappa Gin. Yeah, that's working. There we have it. We have a winner for the Word Add-In. Custom tab in here. Get started with your sample add-in. Got it. And now if I click on this, you see the ribbon with my separate command group. Oh, really? Content is blocked because it's it isn't signed by a file. Yeah. If you create a new add-in, the add-in, the website that you create needs to have a valid certificate on it. And at this time, I haven't created the certificate yet. So let's move back to the original project that we were working on. Don't save. As we now found the issue, go back to the original project. See the test command. Starter one, code. Now I have two open, close the other one. Which one is which one? This is two, this one can be closed. And make this full screen. So what we missed in here, and we need to redo this now, is, let's first see if it's not working. NPM start. That would show us that it's failing. Yeah, it's failing. Add-in is no longer available, but it's not the reason. The reason is that the manifest is just incorrect. So close this as well. And now copy the label. Copy. And put it in the same tab. It needs a resource ID, tab, custom tab. And what are we going to put in there? A new resource ID, tab. So we have the string that's represented on the tab of the on the custom tab, live coding tab, this should do it. By the way, you can add all kinds of commands to your chat window. I think it's commands, yes. If you open this, you see all the commands available. And there are some custom tabs available, like in here, say project. That's showing what we are working on today, like working on Office.js API. And we extend the office host applications, in this case like Word, as we've seen. But you can also look up your points. If you're long enough in the stream, then you get points for this. And I have no 0 points because I'm excluded from points. But if you put in your points, you get your own points per list. And there should be also a leaderboard, I think. Leaderboard. That's another link. If you open that, let's see what's on the leaderboard today. Then you can see that Larks is on the top of the list. PV Menace GG are already in number 5. So I just put the points in, I think, a couple of days ago. So it's not really a valid representation. But anyway, if you want to see your points, just enter points in your command window, in the chat window. What did we do? Yeah, we changed the manifest to create a custom tab in here. And with the custom tab, we should now get a new ribbon. NPM start. Little blackout there. It's early in the morning for me, so bear with me. Loading node. In the background you already should see, and it does show you the new custom live coding tab. And from my previous builds, I was lacking the tab for the add-in, so it was not able to run it. Now you see the custom button in here, show task pane, with the live coding commands label. And there's the error of word again that I need to get rid of. And if you click this, we should see a custom task pane, and it's not. The content is blocked because it's signed by valid security certificate. Restart. Restart, restart. So why is this changed? This is the custom tab 1. Isn't signed by a valid security certificate, so that's interesting. Let's see the website that it's starting. It should be on the localhost 3000. Did my certificate just expire? That would be sad. HTTPS. Localhost. Host 3000. Not secure. Certificate is invalid. I think it expired. Really, it expired today. Come on. My certificate expired today. AM. It's exactly this morning. No, it is not. It's really, it expired just a half an hour ago. That's sad. So now I need to create a new certificate in here. And obviously I completely forgot how to do that. Cert manager. CRT, MGR. Come on. Like this. Let's see what's in here. Trusted root certificates. Localhost. Expiration date. Twenty-one nine. So this is expired. Yes, so that can be deleted. This is always the pain point in developing websites that needs to be secure. So this is expired as well. Then that's also expired. A lot of this stuff is expired. Localhost CA. Office extensibility. I think this one is used by Script Lab. So now I probably deleted all the local certificates. Let's find out if the application is generating a new one. If there's no one available. Because it's, you already have trusted access to localhost. Localhost, blah, blah, and then it's not creating a new one. So let's try it again. But now, when deleting the add-in, the certificate, let's see if it's what it contains in here. Is there a folder in here? Source. Wow, it's really raining outside right now. See if there is something like, oh no. Not finding it in here. I want to find it in here. Cert. Registry and it's creating a certificate in here. Creates one on the fly, apparently. Make cert. Let's run this and see what it's doing. NPM start. What did it say? Already have trusted access, so it is not creating a new one. Is what I guess. No. Pain. Google create certificate office JS. If you're prompted to create an add-in, a certificate. Should use HTTPS, and that's true. Prompt to install the certificate. It says already has access to my local host. Maybe I have a local one. There's a local one. Expiration date 24. It's not in here. Sort. What's this? Enterprise Trust, Trusted Publishers. Most likely need to generate one again. What was this pointing to? Key, see users live coded to localhost. See users live coded to office settings, certificates, and this is probably the certificate that it's trying to create. And that's expired. What's the authority in here? Developer CA for Microsoft Office, and this is 11:28. Do I still have it open? Where is it here? Developer CA. Trusted authorities. Is it in here? Microsoft. Issued by let's see what's in there. Issuer developer CA for Microsoft Office add-ins. I don't see it in here. So let's put this aside. See temp. Put that aside. Then close node. You already had Word closed, I think. Yeah. Go back to the code, npm start. Let's see if it generates a new one now. Uninstalling. Do you want to delete the following store? Developer CA from the root store. That's interesting. a root store. There's nothing in the root. But yes, I want to do that. Do the lead from root source, developer CA again. Yes. Yes, and it keeps. Oh yeah, there it is. No, 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 no. You are about to install a certificate. This is nice. This is creating a new one. Developer CA from Microsoft cannot validate. Blah blah. Where is it going to be stored then? Anyway, I want to do this. Installing a CA certificate. You now have trusted access to local host. Waiting for the server to kick in. There it is. Now we have a custom tab. And see if this is working. Yay! We have a winner! Ta-da! So, it's about 8 a.m. Right now. I need to go to my work. It actually worked. Let's get back to the main screen. So, what we've seen today is that we can create a custom tab. Let's quickly go back to the application that we created a custom tab in the Word environment. Usually that's your common ribbon files. And with this custom tab, you have your own button in here and you can kick in the task pane, but you can also do some other things in your custom tab. As you can see, for instance, with the script lab that has several group items and even an about section. So that's something we want to do next time, expanding it a little bit more and see what we can do within the custom tab. At least what we also fixed was change over the certificate that was apparently expired this morning. And how is that a coincidence? Also a pain point to create a new certificate. But anyway, we got it to work, and that's a good thing. So very happy with that. See, we really made some progress today, and let's close up the stream for today. I will be back next morning. That's tomorrow morning, Friday. That's Black Friday for most people buying cheap things on the interwebs. I already bought my stream lighting. I just have now this small lighting over there, and that's not too good for the stream. And maybe you get some other bargains as well. Yeah, thanks, PVManageGG. I'm not sure how to pronounce this. Thanks for watching, thanks for stepping by and chatting with me in the chat window, and hopefully see you some other time. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.